मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू साइंस ऑनलाइन क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर एब्सोल्युटली फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल एट योर होम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स, सो लेट्स एक्सटेंड द सेम थिंग इन टूडेज क्लास। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स बिगिन टूडेज क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द common things between acid and base, okay? So here we are going to discuss the concept of what do all acids and all base have in common, okay? What are the things are common in acid and base, okay? So here both acids and bases are electrolytes. Electrolytes means it is a good conductor of electricity, okay? So both acids and base are electrolyte, which means they are a good conductor of electricity. It means the electricity is passes through rapidly here, okay? So what is the main common thing here? That is the acids and base have a common thing that they both are the electrolytes, as well as they producing ions in water solution. Ions means which type of ions? That is the H plus ion as acid and OH minus ion as a base, okay? So these are the ions which is produced in solutions, okay? So acid releases hydrogen ions, that is the H plus, whereas bases release hydroxide ions, that is the OH minus, okay dear students? So what are the main common things are there in acid and base? That they both are the good conductor of electricity, okay? They both are the good conductor of electricity, or you can say electrolytes, okay? So dear students, I hope there is no confusion till now. Okay, let's do one activity to understand whether they both are the good conductor of electricity or not, okay dear students? So this is one diagram in screen, okay? So what is that diagram? This is one of the beaker, okay? It is made up of glass. In that we have poured a dilute HCl solution. Dilute HCl solution means it is not a pure form of a acid, it is a little bit diluted, okay? So diluted HCl solution. In that we have kept a rubber cork. In that what we have done, we have attached to the iron nail, and later on we have connected to the battery, bulb and the switch, okay? So these are the apparatus arrangement to show the activity, okay? So later on we are going to discuss the observation. First let us check what we have taken. So take a solutions of glucose, alcohol, hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid, four things we have taken here, okay? So here fix two nails on a cork. Okay, so already we have fixed here. So fix two nails on a cork and place the cork in a 100 ml beaker. So what is the measurement of this beaker? That is, it is a 100 ml. Okay, then connect the nails. We have connected already. Connect the nails with the two terminals of 6 volt battery through a bulb and a switch. Okay, so already we have connected here. Then now pour some dilute HCl in the beaker and switch on the current, okay? After pouring the HCl, that is the acid, switch on the current, okay? Then repeat with the dilute sulfuric acid. How we have done with the HCl, same thing you have to be go with the sulfuric acid also. Now the question we have, that what do you observe? Okay, so you have to repeat this experiment separately with glucose and alcohol solutions also. So what do you have observed with glucose, alcohol, hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid? Okay, totally four things we have taken here for repeating this experiment to check whether they are the good conductor of electricity or not. So this is our activity. Let us understand the observation part. So the first observation we have taken here, that the bulb will start glowing in the case of acids, okay? So when we have taken the acid, that is the dilute HCl, the bulb will glow. glow means what happens, these are the good conductor of electricity, okay. And next is the, but you will observe that glucose and alcohol solution do not conduct electricity, okay. So glucose and alcohol, they both are not good conductor of electricity, it means they both are not a good conductor of electricity. So glowing of the bulb indicates that there is a flow of electric current through the solution, and the electric current is carried through the solutions by ions. So dear students, what do you mean by the glowing here? It indicates there is a flow of current, okay, in this connection. What you can observe, there is a flow of current, okay, there is a flow of current, so that's why bulb is glowing here. Okay, so how this current is carried out? Through the ions. Okay, what are those ions? That is the cation and anion. Okay, so since the cation presents in acid as a H plus, and this suggested that acid produces hydrogen ions in aqueous solutions which are responsible for their acidic property. Okay dear students, so till now what we have discussed, we are taking the observation whether when we have taken the acid, the electric current flows or not, okay. So you can observe here, there is a conducting of electricity, flowing of electricity, okay. So in the acid, it is a good conductor of electricity, so you can observe here flow of current in the form of cations, okay. So what is that cation? That is the H plus ions. So this is our observation, okay. So next question is, what happens to an acid or a base, okay, what happens to an acid or a base in a water solution, okay. So let us understand this thing. You can observe here the figure number 4, that is the preparation of HCl gas. So dear students, already you know that HCl is very strong acid. So we have to prepare in the form of gas, but usually HCl, it is present in the which form? That is the liquid form. So you have to take about 1 gram of solid NaCl. What is that NaCl? It is one of type of salt. So where you have to take here, that is the clean and dry test tube, and set up the apparatus as shown in the figure. So you have to take here one test tube, this is the sodium chloride, filled with a sodium chloride, and after that with the help of conical flask you have to add their concentrated H2SO4, okay. So you can see here in this image how the person is adding here the concentrated H2SO4. So you have to add some concentrated sulfuric acid to the test tube. First, what we have taken? We have taken the NaCl, that is the sodium chloride. Then later on, what you have to be add here? You have to be add here sulfuric acid. So what do you observe? Is there is a gas coming out of the delivery tube? So you have to observe whether the gas is formation is there or not. So the formation of gas you can observe here. So test the gas evolved successively with dry and wet blue litmus paper. So dear students, first what we have taken? We have taken the NaCl, that is one of the type of salt. Then later on what we have added? We have added the sulfuric acid. Then the formation of gas you can find here. So which type of gas it is, whether it is showing acidic property or basic property, we have to check by the blue litmus paper. So here, in which case does the litmus paper change color, okay. So just go for the indicators concept. In the indicator concept, what we have learned, when the blue paper is there, blue litmus paper, acidic property, okay. So what is the acidic property? Blue litmus paper will change into the red in color. So that's why it's showing the acidic property of the substance, okay. So here, on the basis of the above activity, what do you infer about the acidic character? So dry HCl gas solution or dry HCl gas solution, so which property is showing? It is showing the acidic property. So there is a formation of HCl, okay. So let us check the observation. So the experiment suggested that hydrogen ions in HCl are produced in the presence of water. So dear students, in the presence of water itself, it is going to be showing the property of releasing of H plus ions. Already we have discussed that in the aqueous solution, acid is producing H plus ions. Okay. So here, what is the formation? That is the HCl plus H2O. It gives rise the H3O plus Cl minus. Okay. So it is a hydronium ion. That is the H3O plus. So dear students, when the hydrogen ions cannot exist alone, but they exist after combining with water molecules, so thus hydrogen ions must always be known as a hydronium ion. The question can be asked, what do you mean by hydronium ion? That is, it can, hydrogen ions, it cannot be existing lonely, or you can say it cannot be exist alone, but they existing after combining with water. So dear students, when H2O, it adding here H ions, so what it rise? It rise the H3O plus. So this is nothing but the hydronium ion. Keep in your mind, what do you mean by hydronium ion? Here the addition of hydrogen into the water, it gives as a hydronium ion. Okay. So already I have shown you, so this is our example that H plus is adding into the water, it gives a hydronium ion. So it is our observation that in the aqueous solution hydrogen ions is producing or releasing. So this we have done with the water. So in the water, what happened? You can observe here H plus ions is releasing. What about the base? So next question we have, that what happens when a base is dissolved into the water? Okay, base is nothing but the KOH, NaOH. So these are the examples of bases. Okay, so NaOH, if it is dissolved into water, it separated the cations and the anions. So OH minus is releasing here. In similar way, if you are taking the KOH, okay, potassium hydroxide, after adding the water, again it is releasing the OH minus ion. If you are taking the magnesium hydroxide, so after adding the water, it is also releasing the OH ions, OH minus ions. So these are the some example when base is dissolved into the water. So base generates hydroxide ions into water, and base which are soluble in water are called as a alkalis. So the one marks question can be asked, what do you mean by alkalis? So the base, those type of base which are soluble in water is called as a alkalis. Okay, so keep in your mind, what do you mean by alkalis? That base which are soluble in water are called as a alkalis. So dear students, just it is one of the information related to you that all bases do not dissolve in water, and alkali is the base that dissolve into water. They are soapy to touch, bitter, and the corrosive also. Corrosive means it gets a corrosion to the material. If you are keeping the base into the beside of any kind of the metals, if metal is more reactive, then what happen? It get corroded here. Okay, so all bases do not dissolve into the water, and alkali is the base that dissolve in water. And which type of criteria they are producing? They are soapy to touch, bitter, and the corrosive. And never test or touch them as they are causes to harm to our body. Okay, so we do not touch such type of bases because it is harmful for our body. Let us understand one more concept, that what we have identified. Okay, we have identified that all acid generate H plus ions and all bases generate OH minus ions. So we can view the neutralization reactions as follows, that acid plus base, it gives rise to the salt, plus water. Okay, so dear students, keep in your mind, when the acid and base both are reacting with each other, they producing salt as well as the water. Okay, so it is the general formula to show the neutralization reaction, that HX is nothing but representing as a acid, MOH, okay, it representing as a base. So what do you mean by the salt? That is the MX. Here the MX formation, that is the salt formation, you can analyze here, as well as how the releasing ions, that is the H plus by acid, OH minus by base, okay, it is produced by acid, it is produced by base, both reacting with each other, it forms as a water. Okay, so here you can observe the neutralization reaction. When acid and base react with each other, it gives the salt as well as the water. So dear students, till now we have discussed what are the things are common in acid and base, whether they are producing ions or not. Okay, we have done some activity, how the criteria is in aqueous solution. So many things we have discussed. In next class, we are going to discuss some more aspects related to acid base itself. So dear students, just revise all the things what we have till now. Okay, if you are finding any difficulty, just approach me. Once again, I am ready to explain you. So let's meet in the next class. Have a good day. Bye bye.